episode of Miniatures, Magic, and More. My name is Nathaniel Tucker, and today I will be discussing with y'all the subject of painting, building armies, conquering the world in the darkness of the undead. Today I will be discussing how to build your own army, and to use that as the impetus to drive forward your schemes for world domination through your forces. Also known as painting them. But nonetheless, today I will show you how to do that. The first and most important thing is to decide which faction you will play. Now, of course, you can play whatever you like. You can play the dreaded Greenskins, the heroic empire, the chaotic forces of chaos. But for this episode, we'll be focusing on the undead. For that is where my army truly lies. Today, I will be building a 1,500 point limit of my army. Though after adding it up, it's actually 1,535. Slightly 35 points off. But nonetheless, it is a 1,500 point army. And these forces, most of them, are not ready for combat. They are the undead and they are not fully ready. Their appearance is lacking. So my goal is to paint them. Make them a force that will send my opponent crawling into the corner of fear. For he realizes the true monstrosity he is facing. Today, my first army, 1,500 points limit, is drawn from the Vampire Counts. So now, I will show you what my army will consist of, and how I will begin these tutorials of painting and the strategies for my army. The force of the undead that I will begin painting very soon. This is approximately 1,535 points. But nonetheless, this is a pretty good force to reckon with, and pretty soon I will be discussing the tactics that will be used to accomplish victory over life. So let us begin. First, with lords and heroes. To lead my army is none other than Count Manfred, the Mortalk of Night. He will lead my force into the darkness and will take over those. As you can very well see, he is not yet painted. Then, second in command, will be my vampire mistress. The vampire princess is a level 2 wizard as well. She's not fully painted yet, which means that she will be a continuing project. The themes of this army will probably be red and gray. I haven't exactly made up my mind, but it will definitely have red in it, because these are the vampires, and red is their favorite color. Then, combining my army is a necromancer, level 2 wizard. So my necromancer will lead the force. He will be very, very useful. Guarding the Mortalk of Night will be two Morghasts. Well, Morghast Archai, but I've styled them a little bit differently to where they are armed with blades instead of halberds, but they will count as having halberds. They look cooler with the swords. Then I have a group of 20 zombies. Most of these units are, most of the models in this force are painted, but not totally. So there are 20 zombies in total that I will have to paint. Then, vanguarding the force, I have 10 ghouls with a ghast. These are all painted, which means this will be an easy project. Then, the hammer of my force, the Grave Guard. While I haven't decided whether or not I will do this, they might be led by this White King. He is fully painted, but if I decide to upgrade him to a White King, I will definitely put it in my updates for this force. There's a total of 20 Grave Guard, and thus, gentlemen, we have the force here. All the other details of the artifacts, magic, banners, and other things that cost extra points I will include in my other coming series of videos. But the whole point is to go through my army, painting it bit by bit, and also talking about the forces that I will play with, and also just giving me a good force to paint. I'm looking forward both in feeling and most importantly in painting. Now this is more of a sneak peek than anything, a very long sneak peek. But nonetheless, I will show you all in detail very soon the tactics of this army, the schemes I will use, the color schemes I will use. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. The war is coming. Death is rising. Happy wargaming to you all, and I will see you in the next episode.